In the cold winter morning, everything seems to sparkle with the bubbling exuberance of the passing out gentleman cadets. It is a poignant moment, tempered with the camaraderie of the young men.
Why did you ever party, gentlemen? Please keep quiet and listen. Keep seeing all the cleavage. Another thing. Billets are a girl. I saw it there. It was a 66. Sorry, you missed out the zero in between.
The colors of the academy are steel grey and blood red. Grey for steel denotes strength and resilience, whereas red for blood signifies the ultimate sacrifice in devotion to duty. The public face of not just the academy, but that of the army is on display. Tempered by fire, the passing out gentlemen cadets have been trained in disciplined valor to the extent that now courage becomes a habit and a reflex. They too, like so many before them, carry forward certain virtues: loyalty to comrades, fidelity to an oath, and courage under stress. For without these virtues, an officer and an army are nothing. The creme de la creme of the academy, or the first among equals, take a time-honored bow. The sword of honor, the gold and silver medals, the banner awarded to the best company, are cherished moments in the rearview mirror of time.
Many changes have taken place, but one thing remains the same, that is your task and your duty. You are required to ensure the security of this country against any aggressor. What does that mean for you? It means that you should have to fight, and fight to win. There is no room for the loser. If you lose, don't come back. You will have disgraced the country. The country won't accept you. The people of cities, towns, villages, and gaos where you come from won't look at you. Even your karwali will despise you. As I look around, I see parents, I see relations, I see friends who are looking at you with trust and pride. Make sure, gentlemen, that you don't betray their trust or their pride. May the winds of fortune blow kindly upon you, and may good luck attend all your dealings. I wish you great success. Thank you.
The difference between a bad and a good army is not only a matter of equipment, but also of something in the human spirit. Mere enthusiasm is not enough. Fervor must be controlled, trained, and guided. For 70 years, the Indian Military Academy, nestled in the lap of the Himalayas, has done just that.
Congratulations
to the gentlemen cadets and
their parents.
The building
may now commence.
Granny,
yeah.
The fourth generation. Grandfather, grandmother.
I am a warrior. Fighting is my dharma. I will train my mind, body and spirit to fight. I will excel in all devices and weapons of war, present and future. I will always protect the weak. I will be truthful to bluntness. I will be humane, cultured and compassionate. I will fight and embrace the consequences. God, give me strength that I ask nothing of you.